Hi, it's Kelly and welcome back to MEMORE TV. Today's video, I'm going to show you how to soak your nuts and seeds and why it is so important to do so. So the process of soaking your nuts and seeds is really simple. Ideally, you should do this to all your nuts and seeds. All we're doing is I'm going to put in about a tablespoon of salt, mix that with warm filtered water, add some cold bottled water, and then put the nuts and seeds in, as you'll see now. So the idea of soaking your nuts and seeds is to remove their enzyme inhibitors and get rid of all the anti-nutrients, which are not good for the digestive system. And it also makes them a lot more nutritious. One of the main anti-nutrients is phytic acid. That really prevents your body from absorbing minerals. But you know, if you want a little bit more of an insight and scientific approach to why we do it, I will link Dr. Berg's video in the description below. You can learn the benefits of soaking your nuts and seeds and why it's so important. These are the seeds that I've soaked overnight. And as you can see, how dirty the water is and just the debris that has come off them as well. I'm going to rinse them with just cold water. Look how dirty that water is. Now, just with tap water, I'm going to rinse them. Soak them in filtered water, but with cold, never warm, cold tap water. Rinse them, give them a little shake off, drain for 1 second. So after you rinse the nuts and seeds, rinse them a couple of times, then I'm going to dry them in the oven. Now it's really important that I keep that temperature really low, because once you start to roast them, you can also take a lot of the nutrients out. I don't have a dehydrator yet, but when I get my bigger kitchen, I will get one. I'm just going to sprinkle those over, spread them out. These are my sunflower seeds. Look at that. Look at the color of the water. Now, rinsing. Just make sure you just move it around with your hands. Get all of that. Get the water all the way through as much as possible. Now, if you weren't going to store them and you wanted to eat them straight away, or you're using them straight into a salad that day, you don't need to dry them, to dehydrate them, as long as you like the taste of that. And just rinse that again. And these are my pumpkin seeds. I don't mind rinsing it with tap water because they're not soaking in it. Remember, when you're soaking them, it must be filtered water because they will absorb quite a lot of the water. This is my third tray. Just spreading them out. You know, the thinner the layer, the quicker they will dry. So I've just placed them in the oven. Try not to go over 160 degrees Fahrenheit, because then you can also take a lot of the nutrients out of their nuts and seeds. That in my oven's converted to about 65 degrees Celsius. So really, really low heat for 12 to 24 hours. I left them overnight for about 12 hours. I checked them before I went to bed and I had them on the lowest heat. I was able to put it just under 50 degrees Celsius. And if you're working with Fahrenheit, you shouldn't go over 115 degrees Fahrenheit. So it worked, but of course, if you have a dehydrator, it's so much easier. The point of drying the nuts and seeds especially if you want to store them in the pantry, is you want to make sure you get all the moisture out, because otherwise they'll go moldy. And you don't want to overheat them, because you will reduce the nutrients in the nuts and seeds. But always test them, make sure they're crunchy, and then store them. So how I store them, keep it simple. Make sure it's airtight, either jars or these lovely little airtight glass containers. One I did previously, and what I usually do, which I love to do, is mix the seeds together, because this is perfect to sprinkle over any one of my summer salads or any one of my paleo salads, to be honest. The nuts I do keep separate because I just like to nibble on them in the afternoon. Protein. Just make sure it's airtight and they should last in the cupboard for about 6 to 12 months. If you've enjoyed this video, remember I do lots of other videos on paleo, beauty and lifestyle, so please subscribe and you can find me on social media at memoretv. And then wake up!